Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and this video I just want to talk a little bit more about my overall thoughts on the game Murdered Soul Suspect, which I've been playing on my PlayStation 3, and recently that's the videos of me playing and talking, I kind of uploaded that on the channel. It's not a full entire kind of playthrough or walkthrough or what have you, I just thought, hey, this would be a good time to start recording and while I'm playing, and I recorded uploaded a couple of those on my channel. Since then, I finished the game, I completed playing the game, and the ending parts of the game are actually really interesting, and I kind of feel bad that I didn't get to record that and put it up there, because it does have quite an interesting ending. I've been reading some reviews about this game that were like, oh, you know, you can tell from the first hour like how it's going to end, and it's so predictable and whatnot. The story is not interesting, and it's boring. There's a lot of... There's not many reviews. The few reviews that I did read from the users and whatnot were kind of negative. And I guess at best, this is a very mediocre game. It is a very interesting concept, though. The game starts with the main character of the game dying. And you play as a ghost of the dead character. And you're kind of going around and you're investigating why you died, how you died. And whatnot. I didn't really think the ending was all that predictable. I thought it was kind of, whoa, okay, so that's where it's going with that. And it gives you kind of clues in the end. I think the last video that I uploaded on Murdered Soul Suspect was a video in which we're in the museum of Salem Witch Trials, and there's kind of all these torture devices, and it's in Salem, Massachusetts, so the historical events of the Salem Witch Trials is kind of tied into it. Of course it has to tie into it because it's in Salem. You know, it's kind of cliche like that, but it does kind of tie into the whole Salem witch trial thing. And then after the museum, you find out Baxter, you know, who was another kind of police officer who the main character Ronan did not get along with. Baxter had this picture of the mansion house, you know, the governor's mansion, and that's where we go, and then that's where kind of these demons are there, and it's kind of really annoying. The actual game part of the game can be kind of annoying because you're supposed to be stealthy-ish and kind of strike the demons from the behind, but you know, as a ghost, there's not really much of a stealthy way of being. You can't take cover, you just kind of have to go back and see through the walls. The mechanics are there, and it stays the same throughout from the beginning of the game to the end of the game. Is you can pass through walls and you gain the teleport ability near the middle of the game. But even so, and you can hide in like these interferences, and so you can hide there. But in the later parts of the game, the places you can hide just like disappear. So the game aspect is very frustrating. A lot of it is just like walking around and finding little pieces to collect. And when you do collect all pieces of a story arc, you get to unlock a hidden flashback sequence, which is actually, I did that for one story arc. It was actually kind of interesting how somebody died and the kind of, the person's kind of retelling the story. But, you know, whatever. And then, so yeah, the game kind of tries to clue you in this. Oh, it's your friend Baxter, who's actually the killer. You go to there, and this. So now I'm going to go into all the spoiler territories. You know, you go there, and you go into the governor's mansion, and it's pretty much just like two difficult sections of avoiding demons and getting rid of the demons. You get there, Baxter is dead, you know, and you meet with the ghost of Baxter, and then you realize, oh shit, you know, there's something more deeper going on. You go into there, and then you investigate the clues to figure out, oh, this girl Elizabeth that been kind of creeping out from you in the beginning, she was killed during the Salem witch trial because she accused all these witches of being witches, and so she was the one who was kind of mainly behind the whole hysteria, according to the game. It's not really very historical, you know. And so it's like, oh shit, it's Elizabeth that's been kind of been at the core of this. And so you go back to the museum because the girl that you've been protecting all along, Joy, she's held captive by Rex, your brother-in-law, the main character's brother-in-law. And you get there and it's like, holy crap, Rex is holding Joy hostage, and then he's about to like kill her the way Elizabeth died, and so that's when it's like, oh, Elizabeth is able to possess people, and so that's kind of the climax there, and that's how the game ends. The game in a lot of ways feels like not much of a game. It feels more like kind of a movie that you just kind of push along. It's a very slow-paced movie, if it is a movie. And it only gets really interesting near the end. And at the very end, the kind of final kind of shocker was just like, oh, so it was Ronan was actually part of this too, the whole ghost conspiracy thing. It's really interesting. I think the overall story is not bad, actually, especially near the ending part. Like, I was kind of playing this game just to find out how's it going to end. But the game aspect of it is just walking around as a ghost, I guess. That's the novelty wears off really quickly is a problem with this game. And the way they could have done, like, a lot of the side quests could have been more interesting than just you having to walk around and find little pieces and do flashbacks, and then it asks you find clues, and you have to figure out the order of the clues. That's kind of the puzzle aspect of it. It's not really much of a puzzle. It's not a very challenging game. What is really interesting, though, is that, you know, so many games I put in my PlayStation 3, the first thing that it asks me to do is download this patch or download this day one update, or you have to install the game. This game, no mandatory install, and no updates at all, which was amazing. I felt like I popped in the game, I clicked on the game to play, and then I just played it. That was it. There's no other, nothing else. And you know, in the game data that gets saved after I play each game, there's no record of Murder Soul Suspect because it doesn't require any kind of install at all. It doesn't require any downloading of patches. Like, I was like, whoa, so they released this game complete. Like, they didn't think to, this is the game they meant to release. It was released, and they were happy with it. So that's the message I get with it, which is kind of rare now. There's not many games like that gets released like that anymore. It's always like, here's this game, oh, wait, but we forgot this one thing, so actually we're going to patch it, or we're going to give you this update. Actually, there's this true ending that we want to give you to DLC of if you want to pay for that. So there's DLC ending, DLC side missions, DLC side quests, and all that. None of that with Murder Soul Spec. I appreciated that. Also, the fact that, you know, I have a 60GB PS3, so my memory space is limited, so not being forced to do a mandatory install is quite nice. I do have a 250GB hard drive that I could put into, but, you know, there's so many saves in this older hard drive that I'm keeping it in there. But I appreciated that. So, overall, I think it's a pretty, you know, it's a good game to try out to rental on whatnot. It's not really, I can't really find a parallel to this game. It's not like, you know, a typical kind of this game. This genre is coming to be bigger, I guess. You know, the kind of Heavy Rain or Beyond Two Souls or The Walking Dead, the game, the Telltale games, whatever. It's not like those kind of games. It really is just walking around and talking to people, and watching cutscenes, and collecting kind of stuff in the game area, and then figuring out the question. And there's a very basic. You can get questions wrong. There's no penalty for that. You just have to keep trying. And that's it. My overall thoughts, it was interesting. And near the ending moments was quite interesting because of the story. But it does get dragged down, like, just walking around. And it's very cliche, the settings that you'll go to as a ghost game. You know, you'll go to a church, of course. You go to a mental asylum. You'll go to a prison. The headquarters of the police officers. And you'll go to a little underground cellar. And you go to a museum. You know, these are very cliche settings. Oh, in the graveyard, of course, a cemetery. How could I not have remember that one? So, I do like the character Joy a lot. The way she kind of interacted with Ronan was really cool. But it's also cliche in the sense that every character that you come across, except for Joy, will probably die. and Rex, you know, those two are the main characters that are like the main characters. Everyone else, like, I saved you. Oh crap, you know, So, very cliche. So I guess that's what the reviews meant by it's a predictable story. I'm not sure if the ending is that predictable, at least to me. But the overall story is like super, super cliche. If this was released as a movie and not as a game, it would just be... Well, even as a game, it's been largely ignored by the gaming community. So I think if it was released as a movie, it would have been just ignored even more. It wouldn't be talked about. As a game, is a unique concept. But even so, you know, the way they kind of executed this game, just like very meh, you know? But that's my thoughts on it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.